Hey guys. I wanted to share my thoughts on marijuana, so I decided to make this video. Keep in mind that this is only my opinion and it doesn't matter, so take everything I say with a kilo of salt. With that being said, let's dive into the video of why legalizing marijuana is unnecessary. It is my job to know all medicines, their side effects and so on. But this doesn't make me an expert on marijuana. In fact, we didn't touch much on the topic in class, and the topic is certainly taboo in practice. So in general, not much is known about it. Marijuana as a plant, and the chemical substances it embodies, has not yet been fully studied and is not yet completely understood. Therefore, anyone claiming to be an expert on the subject of marijuana is lying, since we do not know all there is to know about this herb. With that being said, I have been educated with what little scientific info we have on this substance, and will use my personal experience with the herb, in order to fill some of the holes in my knowledge. I cannot explicitly tell you that marijuana is a beneficial or malignant plant, because the truth is much more complicating than that. When looking at its use as a medical substance, is it really worth it to damage your lungs in order to manage your anxiety, depression and back pain, when there are safer and more efficient products on the market? Is it okay to prescribe marijuana to a terminally ill patient for pain and depression management since they are, well, terminally ill? How severely must this product be regulated if it is legalized for medical use? These questions can only be answered after the Government and Medicines Regulatory Authority has made a final decision on the matter, and thus we will have to wait patiently and see. All we can do for now is speculate, and in my opinion, it is not worth it. Like I said, there are other substances available on the market that are safer, more efficient at treating the disease and is also legal. Out of curiosity, I tested the substance for myself. Being on your feet at work all day can cause some serious muscle pain. Add high levels of stress to the mix and we have some anxiety as well, which is perfect. So, I tested marijuana against regulated medical substances and found some interesting results. For instance, prescribed painkillers statistically significantly outperformed marijuana on pain management and recovery from inflammation. Interestingly, on an acute scale, marijuana outperformed prescribed benzodiazepines on anxiety management. Unfortunately, this only lasted a few days. My body built a tolerance to marijuana so fast and to such an extent that I was basically smoking air after 2 weeks. It is because of this that using marijuana to treat a medical illness is pointless, because of how rapidly the human body builds tolerance toward the drug. Add to the fact that marijuana is stored in fat and slowly released, and you get a tolerance so fast that it is not worth the damage to your lungs. To me, using marijuana to treat a disease instead of a tested and safe alternative is like using heroin instead of morphine for pain management, or nicotine instead of orphenadrine as muscle relaxant, or alcohol instead of sodium valproate for epilepsy management. Just because a substance has an effect on a disease, doesn't mean it should be freely used to treat that disease. And that is the point I am trying to get across. I believe that marijuana has its place in the world, but it should not be over-glorified. It should not be sold as a wonder drug. One thing positive so far that has come out of marijuana research is CBD products. It is available for purchase legally, and can be ingested rather than smoked. It has mild calming effects and works great for mild irritation or stress. But I would not recommend it for a person with serious health issues. But this is obvious, isn't it? If you are having trouble with pain, anxiety and depression, it is logical to book an appointment with your doctor, rather than smoke a plant. When looking at the financial side, a doctor's consultation, along with basic antidepressants and benzodiazepines, are much cheaper than a month's supply of weed. I'm also positive that SSRIs don't cause COPD. It is in my opinion that the public refrain from unnecessarily using the herb, at least until we have a better understanding of what makes it tick. As I mentioned earlier, this is only my opinion, and I can't stress this enough, I don't want to influence anyone's worldview with this video, I merely seek a platform on which I can express my feelings. This is basically free therapy. In conclusion, if you want to use it, then use it. I say it is within your human rights to do so. But remember, with every right comes a responsibility, a fact that many today have forgotten. I think I'm going to end it here. Please like the video if you agree and remember to comment your thoughts. Until next time. Peace.